Who would fund it?
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأمثال أجمعين. Now brother won't ask the question. Wish inshallah can answer.
We were talking about last week social media platforms, and certain people are moving away from these social media platforms like Facebook, YouTube. What I want to ask you is, why is it that the Muslim family have not got their own social media platform?
Rana, you have to know, to answer this question, you have to know the reality of the Muslim Ummah. The Muslim Ummah extend from Indonesia, archipelago of Indonesia, yes, which is 2,000 little island and big islands, to Morocco and Mauritania, yes, this east to west, and from Albania up north and Turkmenistan, Tajikistan, Turkestan, all these Russian republics till central Africa. What happened to this big land 200 years? Before the collapse of the Ottoman state, what happened? I tell you, the West, who claim Jesus loves you, peace be upon him, yes, went to these countries and slaughtered. In Namibia, they slaughtered 75%. Everywhere, in Morocco, in Algeria, in Egypt, in Palestine, everywhere, we come in to stay, and we're gonna change your language. You have to speak our language. And we're gonna steal all your wealth and bring it back to our country, and you have to follow. They raised, for 200 years, they say, raising slaves or house nigger, people who come to work for me. You are a slave, but I'm going to give you nice food, nice clothing, but you are a slave. And you do the dirt work for me, like Sunak here, and like this Suela, the lizard woman.
Braverman.
You become the home secretary. You do the dirt work. Anybody ask us, I'm sorry. He's Indian woman, he's not us. You are not the white man. So this is what happened in our country. From Malaysia to Thailand. Thailand was... Philippines was Muslim country.
I'm with you, yeah.
So, they went in, slaughtered millions and millions, like they done before to Australia and New Zealand and America and South America. And after that, after they appointed the house nigga, they said, okay, there's a lot of resistance. We're going to go out. But before we go out, we have to divide. Who going down this? Sykes-Picot. One French and one British. We're going to draw lines to divide these countries. And you have to be very careful in drawing this border. They have to be in a critical. We have to make it suitable to produce war all the time. We come to certain tribes, we cut it in half. Another said tribe, we cut it in half, and this, the end gonna be continuous war.
That's how it's always been, Omar.
Divide and conquer. Divide
and rule.
And rule.
Yeah.
And this what
happened. Divide and prosper.
Divide and prosper. And we let some monkeys from this country. We allowed him to come here. Our country, different countries, we allowed him to come. And we're going to use them to psychologically damage the people in back home. So you come here, we give you a filthy job or dirty job, or you sign on, get benefit. And When you go holiday, you show off. You buy second-hand jacket or second-hand trouser, and Armani shoes bloody been worn for 20 years, and you go there and you show, oh, I live in Britain, I'm sexy, okay? But the whole idea is you are a bloody slave. But when you go there, you provoking them. Oh, assalamu alaikum. This guy.
Sorry, I know you're in the middle of a video.
How are you? I want to talk to you, brother.
Yeah, we talk, inshallah, yeah? Just finish up and we're here, inshallah, yeah?
See?
No, let's finish this.
Didn't say assalamu alaikum.
Oh, sorry, brother, okay. Sorry. You have to say assalamu alaikum.
Oh, sorry, forgive me.
This is very bad.
Okay? Sorry, Muslim brother. Forgive me.
Yes. I have.
Assalamu alaikum.
You okay?
Salam.
Everything okay?
How are
you?
Assalamu alaikum.
Thank you for giving my...
What you brother speaking about?
على راحتك على راحتك.
We're speaking about Habibi, about Muslim and the deficiency of the Islamic Ummah. Why we are lost, why we are way behind. And the brother is asking about
social media platform. Where is our social media platform? It's yes. Independent from Zuckerberg and Co. So you can tell your truth. That's where we're at.
Brother,
they decide what happens.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Whatever.
At the moment.
Inshallah.
Whatever you do, brother, I'm going to talk to these guys because these guys, they look new.
Come in. Come in and speak to them about it if you want. Come in.
I'm Shia.
You're Shia?
Shia.
Oh my God.
Shia.
Oh my God. Please, man. Please.
Shia, Rafida.
No.
You know, discuss? You know, discuss a Rafida?
He wants to work with you, ya Sheikh.
Brother, honestly, I don't waste my time.
You don't waste your time.
Zed,
no problem.
For the
what is this about the Quran?
Quran al-Kareem for Quran.
Quran al-Kareem.
Quran al-Kareem. Al-Furqan.
Al-Kareem.
ما يتكلم مش عربي.
لا عربي.
Where are you from, the Arabi?
Pakistan.
And you want to talk about what?
Talk about anything, man. You, Uncle Omar. I want to talk about Uncle Omar, man.
يحبك يا شيخ.
Brother, if he loves me, honestly, I don't want his love, brother.
I get you.
والمؤمنون والمؤمنات بعضهم أولياء بعض. The believer, men and women, they love each other. I thought you're making da'wah with Christian or with Sunni?
Anyone, I don't mind. Sunni.
Anyone, Ahmadi.
I'm a Sunni. You're not Sunni, I'm Sunni. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Inni tariqa feekum wa taqallin kitab Allah wa idrati yahu. So I'm a Sunni because I follow the
Are you Shia?
I'm a Shia of Muhammad and Al Muhammad because of the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Which the best Imam of the Shia you follow? But are you Shia?
No, he's just a, yeah, it'll be all Shia. But go ahead, speak to me.
Are you Shia?
Yeah, Rafida.
Huh?
Shia. No, speak to me, Habib.
Honestly, are you Shia?
Your uncle. Huh? It's my uncle. Speak to me.
Are you Shia?
Don't worry, uncle. Yeah. You're speaking to me, your uncle.
Speak. Why, brother? Let me. Are you Shia?
No problem. I'm Shia.
Where are you from?
I'm from Iraq.
And where are you from?
Iraq.
Are you Shia? Yeah. Oh my God, we got the three musketeers here.
The three musketeers.
Iran and Iran.
Iran is the seven.
Pakistan.
Iran
is the seven. And Pakistan. Which the best scholar in Shia?
The best scholar?
Yeah.
In the Quran, when it says in...
Leave the Quran.
No, it says to ask Ahl al-Dhikr, we say the Ayma Tahirin, Salamullahi alayhi, they are the Hujjah for us.
The Hujjah. The Imam, the best scholar, or the Imam Hujjah? And which recent scholar now? The Imam, رضي الله عنهم, they've gone, passed away. Who are the best?
The Hadith. We take the Hadith of the Imam and the understanding of the Hadith.
Who are the best scholar after the Imam?
Scholars do I take?
Yeah.
Also, we have scholars like Alama Hilli, Alama Bakr Majlisi. You know, like, we have scholars like this.
Kulaini is a compiler.
Kulaini just compiles the Hadith. Kulaini doesn't actually write his own Hadith because. In the time of Imam Sadiq alayhi
salam. So what is the best book of the Kulaini?
No, Kulaini compiled, no.
What he compiled?
Kulaini compiled Al-Kafi.
It went off.
Habibi, no problem. Sheikh Kulaini, he compiled Al-Kafi. He didn't write anything himself. So they gathered 400 usools, which the students of Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, they used to sit, they used to listen to Imam Sadiq, Jafar al-Sadiq alayhi salam. They used to write down everything. They used to write everything he was saying, and they used to have their separate books. So Sheikh Al-Kulaini, over 20 years, he went everywhere and he compiled all these booklets and he put them into one Mus'haf. Now, do you see what I'm saying?
Mus'haf?
Yeah, Mus'haf. It's a compilation, isn't it? Like he made a compilation, isn't it? compilation.
So the Kavi is a Mus'haf.
No, no, sorry, you know what I mean, bro.
It's a volume. How many scholars of the Shia said Quran is stamped with?
No.
This is not the Quran.
No, Aisha said it.
Huh?
Aisha said it. In Sunan Ibn Majah, 1942, she said that the hadith of... I'm not being disrespectful, Habibina. I'm just saying.
Get lost.
He's upset. No, but Abdullah bin Masoud. Abdullah bin Masoud said it. Umar ibn Khattab
said it. You fucking mock Aisha. It's not your face.
Look at this guy, bro.
Don't ever... Smash! Don't ever talk bad ill in front of Aisha.
I'm narrating a hadith, Habibi.
What the hadith said?
Aisha said that Ayat al-Rajam and Hadat al-Kabir came down and a goat came and ate it. In Ibn Majah 1944.
So, if the goat came and ate one piece of Quran. Listen, you Khanzir.
Yeah, relax, bro.
Respect,
SubhanAllah, bro.
When Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu compile.
Uthman,
when he compiled the Quran, did he compile it from who?
Who did he compile it from?
From who? I'm asking you.
The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa
sallam. No, don't tell me the Prophet. I tell you Uthman.
I know Uthman is your Prophet. Is Uthman your Prophet?
Did the Prophet Asim compile the Quran, ya Khanzir?
Yes. He, the Imam Ali used to write down the Quran, word for word. When the Prophet used to say it, and Imam Ali used to be sat describing it. And you have the hadith of Tabaqat al-Kubra, Muhammad bin Sarin. It's the hadith of Muhammad bin Sarin.
So, Ali ibn Abi Talib, Allah, had the Quran written?
He had his own Mus'haf, yeah, he had his own compilation. He presented it to the Sahaba, and the Sahaba rejected it. So he just kept it away.
Okay, the 40 Sahabi who helped in compiling the Quran. And Uthman ibn Affan, yes, make all of them together. So if the goat eat one piece of paper, how about the 40 Sahaba who knows Quran by heart?
Okay, so where's the ayah of Rajam and Radat al-Kabir? If it's the water, Ahsan, this is what I wanted. If the Quran is the water, why did only Aisha? Muta's in the Quran? Is Muta in the Quran?
I believe
in
Muta.
Why? Why?
My mother's married.
Muslim.
My mother's married.
Your sister do Muta?
My mother's married.
Okay. Does your mother in Ramadan take it from the backside? This is in Kafi.
Look at this guy.
This is in Kafi.
Where? You have adult breastfeeding in your books.
Huh?
Breastfeeding.
This is not. This is in Kafi. You tell him. Wow, what's wrong?
What's wrong with you? Speak about it.
Do you believe if you make muta?
Sahaba believe in muta.
If you make muta.
Abdullah ibn Zubair, your Sahaba believe in muta.
Can we finish our conversation?
Your Sahaba done muta.
Please.
I'll be honest, the brother's kind of emotional. I'll be real, he's kind of emotional. I'm just going to leave him. I'm going to leave it at that. Yeah, inshallah. Salam. Barakallah. What's your name, brother? Your name, sorry.
Kennedy.
MashaAllah.
Irish.
I'm going to leave it because the brother's
Thank you, Iran.
I prefer academia.
Iran
here at 7.
And Pakistan. And the Muta. This is the Muta descendant, brother and sister. May Allah bless you from that. May Allah bless you from the Kafi. May Allah bless you. Ali! Radiallahu anhu is mosquito. Al Kafi!
No.
Al Kafi said in his book, Ali! Radiallahu anhu. Is a mosquito.
It's true. It's Tafsir al-Kummi. In al-Kummi. No, why? Imam Ali, without the power of Allah. No, Imam Ali alayhi salam, without the power of Allah, is like
the Shia.
A large kingdom.
The Shia. Say weak hadith. The Shia. Say weak hadith.
Say a prayer. The one in Europe. Come on. Say a prayer.
Go to Iran, man, there is 3 million bastard child there from Muta.
Shia, yeah?
Yeah.
Anyway, you got her.